I love tier list videos. I want to say we're supposed to do a tier list video from 1D to 4D. All the so-called role players in the hobby. This one's Ultimate Programming Languages.
Now actually on duty and being used either by big tech companies or individuals. Some of them are good, some of them are famous, and others are.
What is this? Pick nine? Pick? Looks like COBOL.
Before we dive into my ult.
So he's got SABCDE.
Limit program.
Is that COBOL, by the way?
Yes.
Did we just see some COBOL? No, this is Fortran, isn't this?
No, these four next.
What the hell is this language? It looks like COBOL. I would.
It's got pick. It's a new version. It's not the mainframe version.
Just assume that's COBOL due to the English-like nature of COBOL and the
Before
all
we dive
capital
into
letters.
my ultimate programming tier list, I just want
Okay.
to turn your brain to critical mode, because these tier lists in this matter can be very, very subjective. Fun to watch,
Yeah.
bad to fully rely on. All languages have strengths and weaknesses, and this.
Dude, preface culture needs
Svelte. Some people like Svelte.
to stop, okay? Stop prefacing. Okay, we all know that your tier list is the only one and true tier list. Okay, so just tell us the goods.
Yeah, just tell us. This is the ultimate one, so yeah. Just do it.
Give us why what you're doing is the way you do it. Just give it to us. Give us the meat and give it to us just as raw as possible,
See, a
okay?
language can be easily dropped to wherever the button here is when trying to use it for something it's not designed
Windows.
for. This tier.
What? He had Windows at the bottom? How dare you, sir? How dare you?
A list on YouTube may be a good starting point to discover some new languages and expand your knowledge. They are easy to swallow information and definitely better than reading someone's blog post to tell you that Go is trash as PHP is. However, tier lists in this matter oversimplify.
Did someone just call Go trash? Okay, hey. I think that if you call Go trash, can we be real for a second? I think Go would actually say, yeah, that's, I mean, facts. We're trash.
It's good until Google takes it away. Google giveth and Google taketh. And who knows, maybe one day Google will just take away YouTube. Say, oh, we're not doing it anymore. So every 8 years, Google seems to make things disappear that it's been doing research and development on. And if something is not so much not making money, right now Google's laying off people and like crazy. So expect Google stuff to begin disappearing. Just like when Hangouts disappeared. Said, well, yes, we're spying on everyone who uses Google Hangout. Why not? Obama administration wants us to spy for him. So, oh, we got found out that we're spying on people. And then poof. Google Hangout just disappears. YouTube spying on everybody. One day it might disappear too.
But that's part of the design. We don't have any features because we don't need no features. Features are for the weak. Features are for people who don't want to get things done. Okay? I'm just saying, go as.
The kitchen sink, operating systems and languages, yeah.
Like, it's every time I use Go, I sit there and I grumble the whole time. I'm like, oh, I can't believe I'm using Go. Go is just so simple. It's just all this stuff. And then, like, 5 minutes into it, I'm like, damn, I got that done. I guess I'm moving on with my day. Stupid Go. Go is so stupid and lame. It's just the stupidest thing in the universe. Crap, I have to add another feature. Dang, I got that done super fast. This is stupid, right? It's just like such a trash language that I get everything done in so quickly, and it just pisses me off, okay? I hate being so successful in Go, okay? It just makes me angry. There's no option type. I might get a nil pointer. their formatter puts addition with no spaces, okay?
Simplify complex information and can be misleading for beginners, especially if they were posted by the folks on TikTok.
I like that sound. Where is that from? Was it Mr. Incredible? And he's slowly aging or becoming more uncanny valley as things happen in his life.
I think this is one of the reasons why people now treat these tools as cults or even religions.
Yes.
The tier list you're seeing right now was great.
Okay. What do we got going on here? I don't know. I don't know the levels. What? I mean, what? Well, of course, C is going to be at the top. And then assembler. Yeah, but I don't understand these references on the side here.
With my friend, who's into cybersecurity. The list is obviously not biased. It had one rule. LLVM yeah. gets you up, JVM gets you down. Why? I don't know. We were basically learning about languages right on the spot. I mean, what the hell?
Making a tier list while you're learning a language? That's not uncommon. Just like the guy doing the RPG video. I'm going to teach you about the best RPG systems that I learned about this week.
Hell is this? I lost the footage.
I don't know what that is.
Anyway, Inostalkin, and let us begin.
Alright, let us begin.
Let us.
Lua, a lightweight general purpose language created in 1993.
Hey, where's my Brazilians at?
The Brazilian government language? It is light. It's on the light side. A lot of apps? A lot of apps have Lua built into it.
Go ahead. Brazil, stand up. I said Brazil, stand up.
Brazil.
Yeah, let's go, Brazil. Brazil. By the way, that's how Brazilians laugh, if you don't know. For those that are kind of new here, just joining us, Brazilians laugh in one of two ways, which is, or, I don't know what that last one is, but it's somewhere between a laugh and a war cry. But we know that they love it, okay? I cannot wait to go to Brazil. I'm going to Brazil, by the way. I don't know if you know this. In May. Okay, I'm going to Brazil. Going with Terso. I don't know if you know this. I don't know if you know this. Terso.
The Lua convention or something?
Prime Brazil. Like, it's happening. It's like right here. Okay? Unironically going to Brazil.
Simple, flexible, and one-indexed. It's OOP based. You have an object and methods hanging out of it. I mean, they call objects tables.
Man, this guy is actually describing the language. He's not just going boop, 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 boop with the tier list.
But you get the idea. And before you ask, yes, it has a package manager. It is single-threaded, but you can still use coroutines. It's been...
It's single-threaded is not... I do not believe that is a fair statement. It's single execution like JavaScript. The engine underneath it can still be multi-threaded, but in of itself, you know what I mean? It's single execution. You can have coroutines which will execute like promises or async code in JavaScript. Off by one in Lua happens constantly. I'm always
embedded
off
into
by one.
Different software.
And yes, if we fall short, he's off to Argentina for some tango lessons and empanadas. Yes, this is literally what he said. It's true.
Where Roblox, 5M, wherever is this, and it's used to configure Vim. I use it to create mods for MTA. It's only fault that no big tech company decided to throw money at it. Sit here.
Why you bullying me?
Okay, so that's his mid. Lua is the mid language. Here we go.
I honestly do not think that Lua deserves C tier.
But no big tech company decided to throw money at it. Sit here.
I think the thing that again, these are everybody's own opinions, so we can't take them seriously. But real talk, Lua is a highly embeddable language that is featured just all over the place, anywhere where some where pretty much all embedded applications are going to have Lua somewhere in there. Lua's it's an incredible language for what it does. It's highly embeddable. You have a Rust application and you want to add a little bit of scripting to it, you could throw in Lua in a couple hours and you'll be just running with Lua.
I like it when an app comes with Python, Ruby, and Lua built into it.
No problem. You could raw dog the engine right into your Rust code in like a couple hours. Or you could probably, I'm sure there's a plugin at this point that you just like.
Why are you bullying me?
Why JavaScript,
created in 1995,
that was
it is considered the core language of the World Wide Web. I have been coding in JavaScript for my entire life, and the only thing I can say about it...
JavaScript, it's probably going to go up high. It's going to be up high. Because it's a web thing. It's a browser thing.
It is...
beautiful, elegant, a masterpiece of engineering, human ingenuity.
Not a number. Not a number. What's the value of not a number?
At its finest, truly a stunning, gorgeous...
What was that last one? I don't even know how to read
it. Whoa, whoa. Okay, the string 0 is equal to or less than null. What? No, what? True. What?
This. Okay, this has to be one I've never even heard of. Hold on. Okay, hold on. 0 equals negative null?
Oh, is that how they're spelled? Okay.
Oh, I know what happened.
Equals not null.
I know what happened. Okay, so negative null is negative 0. Yes, classic. And negative 0 is equivalent to 0.
That is so lame.
Think about it. Cast that string to a number, baby. Cast that string to a number, baby.
That's the problem with JavaScript. Strings. What are strings?
A stunning, gorgeous.
By the way, I prefer this one. On. Oh, I thought it was in here. Wait, am I doing this one wrong? Where's that one?
Oh, now it works.
Dang it.
Now it works when he's trying not
Wait,
to
oh
make
yeah.
it work.
You have to put in a number. Yeah, there you go. Nailed it.
There
you
go.
Now that, my friends. Now that's
bum,
a beauty. That's my favorite. That's my favorite one right there. Okay.
That's
my favorite one. Everybody enjoy it. You're welcome.
It just took the last digit.
That last one, this last one, though, that they had right here,
gorgeous.
That's just a number issue. I had this one where I was looking up accounts at Netflix for one of our internal tests, and I kept getting wrong numbers in JavaScript. I mean, it's just 2 to the 53 minus 1, right? Classic. It's just a classic 2 to the 53 minus 1.
Language.
Did here.
Recently, for no reason at all, I asked Mint Mobile's legal team if big wireless companies are allowed to raise prices.
TypeScript or JavaScript with type.
He put JavaScript under Lua? Well, he was pointing out the weirdness. Okay.
Or is it? It was developed by Microsoft to be a superset of JavaScript. Now,
I
want you to imagine how bad JavaScript is
and
double it. The whole less error-prone thing is just a straight lie. Because in TypeScript, types can be sometimes tricky. It lets you typecast wherever the hell you want, and each project requires you to buy another drive, which causes the LSP server and VS to crash every 5 minutes.
Not even a bit.
Dude, that's actually pretty funny. Once you exceed a certain size, of project, TypeScript can be very annoying. When I open up our multi-million line code base, it's like 45 seconds before that thing's ready, and then sometimes it just don't even respond.
Close
TypeScript is neither a programming language nor a JavaScript superset. It's a VS extension. B tier anyway. Python.
Yeah, the script that runs TypeScript just hangs sometimes. Oh. My glorious Python.
I mean, technically he's right. It's not, it's... Is there, well, I mean, I guess it is a...
Well, TypeScript is better than JavaScript. But isn't TypeScript going out? Isn't it phasing out for something else?
Superset, right? Because all valid JavaScript is valid TypeScript. So therefore, it is a proper superset, right? Is there anything that you can do in JavaScript that you cannot do in TypeScript?
Is there like a new version of JavaScript that came out yesterday?
I don't think that's true. So I think it is a proper subset, but I do like it's a VS Code plugin.
Phone. A general purpose programming language created in 1991. Easy to grasp.
These guys jogging with their headbands. What's that about? What is that about?
It is a proper subset, but I do like it's a VS Code plugin.
Phone. A general purpose programming language created in 19.
Is this exactly 1991? This AVI file here.
In 91, easy to grasp and learn for beginners for its oversimplified syntax, large community, yeah. Dynamically typed, heavily used for machine learning and data analysis,
horrible
performance, no constants, everyone hates GIL, numerous compilers, and the try-catch bullshit now is try-accept. Fascinating. I don't know who thought that white space indentation was a good idea anyway. Still, a solid language. B tier.
The thing about white space, tab, no semicolons. Some people, that's a no-go. And they will die on that hill. That's the only complaint they have about Python, really?
Well, moving on to PHP, the loved.
I mean, I do agree. Python's a great language. It's for me though. Python is not a B tier though. Python would only.
Python is general purpose. I don't think it'd be as great as it is if it didn't. If it had no libraries, it would have faded off into the distance somewhere.
Only be S tier or Windows tier in this. There is no in between. I do not believe Python to be a mid-language. I believe Python's either the best language for what it's doing, or it is the worst language you've ever used. There is no in-between.
Like, use Python to make a 300 frames per second Unreal Engine 7, you know, Infinity 3D game set. Some real-time engine with the 5D glasses. Python would not be able to handle that or program that at all. Nope. Python's always in the background. It's always that little background thing that's running. Doing menial tasks. Nothing to do with the video game.
I do not believe in the in-between.
And the most hated. It has no other use case other than web development, which can be easily replaced with any other language. PHP.
Oh, yeah. People are still going to use JavaScript for that. There's Django. I use Bottle. There's Flask. There's a couple others. What are we looking at here? This place looks familiar. What is it?
Developers drive Lambos became a myth. Honestly, it has my favorite keyword. It still has a large community.
Explode was. I do love Explode. I used Explode for so long. The fact that they went with Explode, they didn't even go with like talk or anything like that. They just went with Explode. Well, the French fries.
Despite being old, and it recently got a major update that had typed class constants.
I was going to say, is it still at 8? So it's 8.3. 8.3. I don't know why, but back in the day, a lot of women were doing this PHP stuff. A lot. Don't know what the attraction was to PHP. You know, guys were doing Perl. And the other one, but the women all chose to do PHP.
Deep cloning of read-only properties. Oh, and your JSON validate function.
Oh, Did I just hear a Jason? Did I just hear a Jason? Let's go. Subscribed right there. I'm already subscribed.
Jason.
I am so subscribing right now. I'm jismaling right now.
Evolutionary features. I appreciate the efforts, but eat here. Java.
What?
Class-based
what?
Object-oriented high-level programming.
Hang on. PHP isn't broke. It's just ancient. It still works.
Programming language that is fairly secure and has been the most adopted language through the years. It is strictly typed language. And
was that its adoption curve? That was kind of a sad
language
adoption
that
curve.
That is fairly secure.
Oh,
I hate
scrolling text. Look at
it. Kind of goes up and then stays level. Something happened. Usually when something goes up, something goes down. Like right here. Anyone remember what this was right here? Ooh. Is this the end of Objective-C? And then Swift took over? It's weird. Stuff just kind of shows up.
Look at that adoption curve. Look at that. Ow. Ow. That's an ow. That is not.
From here to here. It's just a slow decline. But something. Two of these guys. This thing, it's kind of running copacetic with this gray one. What's the gray one? C-sharp? I can't tell. Get your arm out of the way.
That's not a good trend line. That is not a trend line you want to be a part of. Oh, is this the Toby index?
Yeah.
If this is the Toby index, I don't trust none.
I mean, it depends on how you prompted it, what you were prompting for. It's very biased. You can make it look very biased. Like, you can make any language look bad using the index if you know what you're doing. You can make Fortran way up here at the top. No, something jumped up here. It just goes. Poop, poop. I mean, that's not Visual Basic. Visual Basic didn't get a jump. Was that Java? Something got a jump. Right here, it just goes from zero to here.
Adopted language through the years. It is strictly typed language.
I hate
and criticized for boilerplate code. It can be used in various fields. Yeah, I tried it once in my entire life. It was, but D tier. Another product we have.
D tier? What? The only problem I would have with Java is if you don't update your Java, your machine gets infected with viruses. You know, they got rid of Shockwave, they got rid of Flash, but they still have Java.
Microsoft is C sharp.
D tier. I don't know. I learned data structures on Java, so I kind of feel like it's a little bit higher for me. Dang it. Java is like, it has this place in my heart. You know what I mean? It has a place in my heart.
I like Java 1.3. 1995. But we didn't know any better back then.
That's like special. You know what I mean? Yeah. I think everybody's first language is special.
It is
first language, HP 2000F Basic. Playing Star Trek 73.
Basically a copy of Java. They even copied the public main class public static void main strings args feature from Java. Then they removed it. It gives you control over memory, despite
well
being
done.
High-level programming language. It
they
also
do have
allows
unsafe.
Asynchronous
I think that's
programming
pretty cool.
And multi-threading. It is cross-platform, kind of. To be honest, I used it only once for the Unity framework. I would prefer it over Java.
Yeah, it's weird how they call it there was F. There was F sharp? That got banned. So then C sharp comes along. It's like C, but it's like Java.
C tier. MATLAB.
Fair. That's actually fair. Fair. Fair take. C Sharp is better than Java. I said it. C Sharp is better than Java. Okay? It just is. I know people don't want to hear that. It just is. It just is.
Haram tier.
Winter sales now live on G2A.com.
You didn't even
take a thrilling sled ride through the hottest digital deal.
He didn't even talk about or was it MATLAB or something? He just sticks it at the bottom. Rust.
But Microsoft is shit tier.
Rust, a memory safe language thanks to the Borrow Checker strict rules that make your life easier. No need for an entire book about pointers when you have books, cell, refcell, rc, arc, mutex, weak, unique rc, pin, and mpin. It has a strong typing.
I to this day still don't quite understand pin and unpin. Like, I understand pin means that it can't move, and unpin means it can move. But all I know is sometimes you gotta throw a pin on it, and sometimes you want to unpin it. I don't know why.
System and features that TypeScript developers don't understand. It also made strings way easier. You know, yes. We only have a string slice, string, CSTR, CString, OSTR, OSString. Yeah, NC for us can be a little bit tricky.
Technically, you can get a U8 vector. There's just
it
a
is
few
the
things.
Favorite for malware developers because, yeah. Good luck reversing that. Also, the Rust Foundation is kind of gay. All that Rust has produced is literally already existing software.
That?
Good luck reversing that. Also, the Rust Foundation is kind of gay.
Really? They put the colors on there? Tell me that was done like in June and they just haven't remembered to change it back.
All that Rust has produced is literally already existing software with color.
The man is brave. The man is a brave man making that joke in today's day and age. Oh my goodness.
Anyway,
well, people have it in their mind that 2024 is when wokeness is undone. But yeah, whatever.
Of it. A tier. C. Great.
Yes!
What? Hang on.
Anyway, I love it. A tier.
Oh, he loves it. He put it there because he loves it. Okay.
C. Great.
Yes! Blazingly fast. Let's go.
That's Arthur C. Clarke talking to a kid about how in the future he'll be using something called the interwebs to shop online.
Oh, got him.
And view the porns with just two clicks away from porns.
Got him. That was awesome. That was so good. I can't even believe it.
In the 70s, the oldest language we have on the list. It's been used to create most of the languages we have talked about so far, and every existing piece of software out there. Minimal and simple, but strong enough to build anything. Probably obsolete, known for memory corruption. It lets you do whatever the hell you want, like dereferencing a pointer that's more likely a null pointer, typecasting with no compile time errors, using uninitialized variables, or my favorite, pointer aliasing. It has one of the best features. Trolling code bases. Everyone wants the speed of C, but no one wants to use C. S tier. C++. The first and the last.
I fully agree with this one, by the way.
No one wants to use C.
I fully agree with that. C is fantastic. C is the tippity top. It's the tippity top.
DLC for C. Created in 1983.
It's a DLC for C.
Often
that's
called
pretty funny.
C with classes. It offers more features than C that work out of the box, while maintaining performance.
I hate scrolling
text. Was criticized for being too featureful. The no memory safety features.
By the way, the too featureful thing is true, and I think Rust is getting hurt from that as well. Rust just has so many effing features, and they just won't stop.
Yeah, Python's the
make
same
more
way.
Features, you know what I mean? It's getting complicated.
We're also inherited from C, with a little bit of spice. Templates are pain in the ass, or most likely a skill issue. Elegant error messages, very comprehensive.
Templates are literally death by... By the way, this is pretty straightforward right here.
Really?
Okay.
Constant in, constant foo, constant in, constant.
This is normal C++ right here. Actually, this is just normal C.
Like how it has constant.
Wait, can you do a reference in C? Or is this C++? This is C++, right? This would be because we have the little reference right here. This is C++. It's very easy. So what you got to do, whenever you see this, this is a const pointer to a constant. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Const pointer to a constant. So that means you can't change the pointer and the underlying value cannot be changed. It's really simple. Like when you read it that way, it makes it really easy.
Syntax.
Why though? Because this is called a real language, one in which you get control over everything. See, in JavaScript land, you don't have control over anything. So actually, in fact, in JavaScript land, you kind of do. So you watch this. Const a equals this array. That is a const pointer to a mutable value. Let me explain. A.foo equals 5. I have just mutated a, but I thought a was constant. No, the pointer to a is constant, not the value of a is constant.
Yep.
Does that make sense? Now, in TypeScript land, if we go to TypeScript land and I go like this, I go const a equals read, is it, where does read only come in at? Read only, is it like that? No, as const, there we go. I literally have as many constants as the other one did, right? Same amount of const pointer to a, it's literally const pointer to a constant. Does that make sense? It's the same thing. It's literally the same thing. So a.foo equals 5. You can't do that.
You can't do it.
But now here's the good part is I believe if you put, like this though, foo foo 1. Okay, good. It's read only. It's read only. So you can't even change it. So this would be a const pointer to a constant.
Yeah. I feel like I'm dealing with what seems like a never-ending stream of emails. Grammarly has helped me be efficient with.
Trust me on this. Don't you ever try to check the std declarations. It's horrible.
No.
It's kind of like a pre-done for you union. It's either a string or a jar. I don't know what a variant is.
Linking errors.
Oh man.
That was cool. I just figured I could check the definition of a variant. That will be easy. It was not easy, dude. TJ was, none of us were ready for this. Look at TJ like, oh no. We're not ready for this. We're not ready for whatever this is. Can you believe someone wrote that code?
Linking errors will cost your soul. Linus hates the language for some reason, and its fans have serious deals with arrestations.
By the way, that Linus, that little Linus one that we just saw right there was actually him saying F you to NVIDIA, not to C++.
Tier.
Nim.
Let's see. I have a place right here. Nice. Go, a statically compiled high-level programming language created by Google in 2007. It is simple and efficient. It has blazingly fast compile time. It has garbage collector, great concurrency model, screw your OOP, has the best package manager, if error doesn't equals nil is a feature, and it's the language I have no opinion on because I'm still learning it. Our note here. React.
Let's go. I actually really like that. No, I love that.
Where
By
did
the way,
you go?
I will have to say that people overestimate the if error equals nil. By the way, you know, just for fun. Okay, I know this is not a stream of that, but you'll notice that I don't have like a ton of error equals nil. Right? I mean, this error check is my own personal error check, but like you notice that you don't see a lot of it, and the reason why is that anytime you're doing code, there's not a lot of if error equals nil. But anytime you're interacting with something that's async or requesting from another service, something that could be flaky due to some sort of hardware, software, whatever issue, then you start getting it. So it happens all the time when you're making like network requests. But it doesn't happen when you're just doing normal, regular, everyday things. So if error equals nil, which, by the way, look at this. Leader EE, like, I'm so ready. I'm so ready for this. You... like, I'm so ready for them, okay? I'm so ready. But it's not nearly as... it's not nearly as bad as people say it is.
It's a case.
It's just not.
It's a case situation.
And yes, if for those that are wondering case what use. That was, if we go here and we go to remaps, I believe, EE, there you go. There's my key set. You can see, literally, look at this. Create a new line. Go into insert mode. Type if error does not equal nil, brace, enter, brace, escape, shift-O to put a new line in between those two, return error, escape. So that way I can end right there. Look how great that is. I just literally type it. It's like the dumbest remap of the universe, but it's so awesome. All right. We're now on to my favorite language, React.
Obviously, there is a hell lot of language.
Before we do that, I don't know. Did you guys see this, by the way? I don't know if you guys saw this. I don't know if you saw this, but look at that. Dan enjoyed HTMX essays. It's kind of cool, huh? I gave him the high-fivey thingy. Anyways, back to React.
Which is, I didn't mention, because either I never worked with them, or they never made it to production. Now, since we have finished ranking, just give me a sec.
Wait, did we just miss React? Hold on.
Is a feature, and it's the language I have no opinion thing? On, because I'm still learning it. Our note here. React. Obviously, there is a hell lot of languages I didn't mention, because either I never worked with them, or they never made it to production. Now, since we have finished ranking, just give me a sec. Yeah, as I said, these tier lists are so subjective. Every language has its quirks and superpowers, although there is some that objectively suck. Yeah, looking at you, JavaScript. But that doesn't change the fact that you shouldn't learn it, or at least check on it. Whether C++ is better than Rust, is JavaScript really obscure? Well, it actually is, but the point is, I just write with whatever makes me happy and what makes sense to use.
I never
though,
was.
If you are using JavaScript, I really doubt that part. If you think there is a single best God-tier language that can do everything, you're just being a fool and a sinner. If you made it this far watching this 18 years old fool with cracked voice talk shit about stuff that are certain.
That's cool.